from the sky the morning after. Pops came back like nothing had happened, as if the open sky had always been his one true home. Only 17 hours had passed since the war began. Duke Tibania's war strategies seemed to be minutely timed to avoid giving Osea any chance to launch a counterattack. I got a notice of assignment as a member of the press corps. I guess Captain Hamilton had pulled a few strings for me. I didn't waste any time going to work. Second Lieutenant Nagase, inside the crew room. She's sitting by herself, writing something in her book. Nobody knew what she was writing. I realized these people may well be the story I was looking for all this time. In fact, I was sure of it.
Attention! Listen up! The biggest mistake Duke Tibania has made in their blitz attack is that it had failed to sink any of our aircraft carriers. We'll evacuate all intact carriers to our inland sea, then use them as a base to rebuild our counter-strike force. You've been called to service on a very important operation, people. Keep that in mind out there.
Today at 1500 hours, three carriers from the 3rd Ocean Naval Fleet will rendezvous at Eaglin Straits. These carriers are the Vulture, the Buzzard, and the Kestrel, which has successfully escaped from Port St. Hewlett, thanks to your help. Your mission is to coordinate with the Kestrel and provide top cover for all carriers during the rendezvous. Should you encounter enemy attack, defend the three carriers at all costs. The situation is fluid. So be sure to choose an aircraft with good defensive capability against both air and ground-based threats.
With this formation, then?
War Dog, launch!
It was nothing. Easiest mission in the world. That's what it was supposed to be. It wasn't just us, but everyone they could get their hands on. General mobilization. Our planes filled the sky like a huge aluminum cloud. There was no way the enemy could attack. The Queens of the Ocean made it to the inland sea. We've got it made in the shade now.
This is Thunderhead. We've arrived outside the range of enemy air attack. Permission granted to return to your assigned bases in sequence. Aircraft may refuel for the return trip if required. Hold above the carrier for the tanker aircraft.
Everyone's starting to leave! Can we go yet?
War Dog Squadron, I told you to wait for the tanker plane above the carrier.
I swear, man. Hey, what is that? Is my radar on the fritz?
It's showing up on mine, too.
Where'd it come from? How come the morons at Thunder Blockhead didn't notice it? Yo, kid!
You have to call him Captain now.
Yeah. Hey, you think we ought to report this?
Enemy approaching! All units, return to your combat air patrol stations! Protect the carriers! We have three carriers. Don't let them sink even one.
Chopper engaging. Archer engaging.
Edge engaging.
Missile hit. I can't take off. Shoot down those enemy planes for me.
Okay, I'm coming. Hold on.
All right, direct hit.
Hurry and launch the carrier jets.
Guys don't know when to quit. It's really starting to tick me off.
Visibility is poor. It's the perfect time and place for a surprise attack. But the timing is too perfect.
Come on, I can do this. I've been through a real battle before.
Hey, come on! We need some air support here.
What
Second missile incoming! Damn it! Listen up! If you want to survive, then climb above 5,000 feet before that thing hits! All units, move it! Kestrel, evasive action! What are we gonna do, kid? I'll follow you!
Are they sure it's 5,000 feet? Trust that information.
I can't gain altitude. Hey guys, I need a little help.
People are spilling off the decks.
Look out, they're bad. Emergency climb.
There goes another ship.
Climb, climb.
Mega 9. 10 seconds to next impact. 8.
Almost there.
7.
5,000 feet.
5. 4. 3. 2. 1. Impact.
He's our captain now.
That's right. And I'll never lose my lead plane again. No matter what.
The enemy attack squadron has withdrawn from the area. The aircraft carriers Vulture and Buzzard were sunk by a powerful burst missile attack. According to hydrophone data analysis, we have determined that the attack was carried out by the Synfaxi, a Yuktobanian underwater attack carrier. The specs of this ship are unknown, but its existence confirms that the advanced shipbuilding efforts of the Yuktobanians have been going on unabated since the previous war. The Synfaxi is a serious threat to our objectives. Emergency transmission from Central. Our army has decided to deploy the military power of the Arkbird to neutralize the grave threat posed by this new enemy submarine.
We set off for the northern region to refuel. This place is paradise compared to what's further ahead. Beyond our destination lies the closed gate to Nord Belka. 15 years ago, the Belkans set off 7 nuclear bombs there to stave off the advancing Allied forces, entombing themselves in the frozen valleys to the north. That bit of history should have been enough of a lesson for us all. The 7 Belkan cities near the gate were vaporized, and the local area is still highly radioactive. Our landing point was in the state of North Ossian, formerly a haven for Belkans, but now entrusted to Ossian lore. If you refer to it by that name in front of the local, we'll put a scowl on his face and tell you that this is South Belka. Skylark meant a lot to us. Our flight training took place here on this airfield. On the base, we were surrounded by junior cadets, eager to hear war stories. The newspaper article about us, written by that journalist Jeanette, made it here faster than we did. Somewhere along the line, we had become the most experienced pilots in the entire world. Directed to take these inexperienced pilots back with us to Sand Island when we returned.
Man, we better thank Pops for this. Right then. Cuz, he's the guy who pounded basic fighter maneuvers into us. Now we can lord it over all these guys.
You said it. These pilots had only a tenuous grasp of flying, much less mid-air refueling, so we had to land at every base along the way. I can't believe we have to send them off to guard the western coastline.
An SSTO craft launch facility lies to the east of our current location, McNeely Air Force Base. The facility was a collaborative project between OSEA and Yukta Bani. It was built to be a bridge to outer space, with a mass driver 7.5 miles in length. Our radar has detected several planes from a Yuktabanian squadron approaching the facility from several directions. The facility is currently conducting pre-launch operations for an SSTO craft. The base commander will provide you with further orders.
This is the commander of McNeely Air Force Base. All units, including those refueling at this base, are now under my command. Engage the incoming enemy. All untrained pilots are barred from taking off. Those guys are still kids.
I remember this space center well. The mass driver was built by OSEA and Yukta Bania as part of their collaborative efforts to construct an international space station. Our anti-war president used the surplus funds that came from cutting the defense budget to build it.
Is that the Arkbird?
The Arkbird. A white bird built as the first step toward the realization of the space station project. Now it's left its orbit and is just low enough to graze the atmosphere. It's coming down to pick up the laser cannon they're about to launch. They were building a bridge of peace that would span into outer space. Not anymore. The machinery meant for this peaceful mission was about to be used for our counterattack.
Yes? Isn't that thing supposed to work like a satellite? Why'd it climb down all this way?
It's a maneuverable orbiting spacecraft.
I know that. I'm just saying, if the system uses atmospheric friction to change its orbit, then wouldn't that make it pretty hard to defend itself?
I guess it'd be in trouble if someone started firing at it right now.
Yeah, so shouldn't it be higher up then?
Continue countdown. 3 minutes to launch.
Halt the countdown! Enemy incoming! This is the Base Air Defense Command. The enemy has a large formation of transport planes escorted by a squadron of fighters. They're conducting an air assault to capture this base.
What? They're actually planning to invade OSEA?
If we shoot the parachutes before the tanks detach, we'll smash them into the ground. You with me? It's cool, but if we don't do it, we won't be able to hold them off.
Airborne tanks are dropping from the transport plane.
Can you count all those parachutes? I gave up already.
Destroy all airborne ACVs. Engage them in the air and on ground.
our close air support to make sure they succeed.
I hate having to shoot you after you finally touch ground and all, but... sorry.
Number 12's parachute was shot away. It's in free fall. We need some help here. How much longer you gonna let him play target practice with us? This isn't funny. These tanks are gonna turn into a coffin soon.
The agility and speed of those tanks are far better than I expected.
Our fuel boxes are getting pummeled. We gotta protect them.
He's right. It'd be crazy to try to launch in the middle of all that enemy fire.
What are we supposed to do? Shoot at planes with our cannons? We're defenseless in the air. Guess we'd better start praying. Damn it, we're trying to crossfire. They're firing us from below, too. We do have parachutes for our tank crews, right? You sure we'll be able to land safely?
Well, don't just stand there. Start shooting! Destroy them before they hit the ground. Be careful. Avoid firing on your allies.
That was a nasty shockwave.
Our ground defense line is collapsing. They're gonna get overrun.
They're halting the countdown after all this?
All that hard work, just down the drain.
This is the Northeast Sector Defense Force. The enemy has broken through Pillbox 1.
What's the status on those airborne tanks? Graham, can you check?
Several of them have already landed, and are executing their attack. We should engage as many of them as possible in front of our defense perimeter.
Yeah, I agree.
I'll try one more time to convince the higher-ups to launch.
Our allies on the ground are mixed in with the enemy. Can't we do anything about that?
Throw the Molotov cocktails!
All Yuktabani and ACVs destroyed. Our thanks to all allied aircraft.
That should be most of them.
It looks like they've abandoned the ground invasion and decided to just destroy the base. Wipe out the remaining enemy forces. Make an effort to minimize any damage to the mass driver. Large number of cruise missiles tracked on the outer edge of our radar coverage. All fighters, engage and destroy these cruise missiles.
Captain, can you detect the cruise missiles from there? I picked them up as well. They're heading for the facility. Look at all those missiles.
The SSTO is gonna get hit if this keeps up.
This is Flight Director Adam Gittleman. Continue SSTO launch. Recommence launch sequence. Attention all personnel. We only have one chance to launch. Let's all do our jobs and see this through to the very end. That is all. Weather team, roger. Flight control team, roger.
Guidance team, roger.
We're being pushed back, little by little.
Whoa, that was close. Come on, we can't waste any more time. The catapult camera just shut off. Was the SSTO hit? The camera just malfunctioned.
I can't shoot them all down!
You'll do fine. Stay calm and you won't miss.
Missile trajectories detected! Moving to intercept! My plane can't keep up with them!
Guidance team reporting! Our launch window will close in a few minutes!
Have faith in our fighter pilots. Don't rush your final checks.
4 minutes to launch. Hold them off till then.
4 minutes? We won't last that long!
Blaze, do you know why the Ark Bird was built? Ironic, isn't it?
Seal off D-Block. Nobody's left in there, right?
Fox 2! Fox 2!
Take the wounded to Warehouse 4!
Here, we're staying.
Is the launch facility safe? I can't tell from here. Ah, good. I'll continue the operation.
3 minutes! 3 minutes to go!
Check on the remote measurement units.
Sorry, sir. Remote measurement units check complete.
We'll be safe here. Calm down. SSTO status report.
Everything's clear. All systems are go.
Yeah, I'm seeing it now. It's a beautiful sight. This is great.
Observation room reporting. The SSTO is climbing smoothly. Congratulations.
The white bird rose up once again, laser cannon in its wings. It was a moving sight. In my heart, though, I wished it didn't have to be used in war.
None of them found out why the enemy targeted the base until much later. Of course, by that time, it was too late.
We prevented the Yuktobanian army from capturing the launch facility. The SSTO launch was successful. The SSTO docked with the Arcbird, which had descended into the upper atmosphere, and successfully transferred a laser weapon module over to the craft. all aircraft for the 108th Tactical Fighter Squadron and the Sand Island Detachment. Return to base as soon as rearming and refueling operations are complete.
You people are like the plague, you know that? The moment you return to Sand Island, this happens.
A large combined force of Yuktobanian vessels and aircraft has been detected advancing in the ocean directly toward Sand Island from the west. Our intelligence has confirmed the presence of amphibious assault ships within the oncoming fleet. We believe the enemy's goal is to conduct a landing operation on Sand Island and capture this base. Close with the enemy, disrupt landing operations, and suppress their naval gunfire directed at our forces ashore.
Even if this turns into a ground war, I am prepared to fight for this island to the bitter end. As my advance guard, I want you to forget everything else and concentrate on dealing a lethal blow to the incoming enemy invasion fleet. We'll be deploying everything we've got. Launch every aircraft capable of anti-ship combat, regardless of combat experience.
Captain, which plane?
Are we launching in this formation?
War Dog, launch.
This is AWACS Thunderhead. All units, listen carefully.
I missed that sweet voice. Say, you get that from your mama's side of the family?
Cut the chatter. First enemy wave, bearing 280 degrees. You are cleared to engage on site.
It's too risky to bring the Nuggets here.
I'm with you on that. You agree, kid? Seriously, they got their hands full just keeping their planes in the air.
Do you all ever get scared, Captain? I see. So you're just like us.
Target hit! This is Sand Island Base Defense! Enemy amphibious force intercepted at the coastline!
Oh, great. Here we go.
Enemy ships are firing towards Sand Island. Stop them! Enemy assault ships are launching attack helicopters. Shoot them down before they reach Sand Island.
This is the Frog Rui. Commencing support fire.
Down by itself. 9, 8, 7.
taxi.
Captain, do you think the Arc bird can really avoid hitting us? Really? But it's accurate enough to shoot down a missile.
Thunderhead, this is Blue Hound. Detecting sounds from Syntaxi indicating imminent missile launch. Arcbird, we'll send the data over as soon as we detect the missile. We're counting on you. So now what? We don't have anything that can touch it that high up. Don't be intimidated. Continue with the attack. Missile away from enemy sub. Locked on. Begin data link.
Trouble.
defensive for a while now. How can a submarine that large even exist?
We haven't finished it off yet.
Enemy sub launching first missile. Brace for impact.
Chopper, box two!
So that bird's got its eyes on us from outer space.
We'll continue with the attack.
The Arcbird was successfully employed over the forward edge of the battle area. The enemy amphibious force attacking Sand Island was repelled, and their invasion plans halted. The underwater carrier Synfaxi, a lethal enemy threat, was engaged and destroyed by the superior firepower of the Arcbird. Having lost the support of the Synfaxi, the remaining Yuktabanian forces retreated. Furthermore, we are requesting reinforcements from Central Command to replace our squadron members lost in combat.
Since we thwarted their invasion, we haven't seen any major offensive operation by the enemy for several weeks. Almost like we're at peace again, eh, people? Anyway, let's start the briefing.
Yuktobanian combat operations have been dormant since their failed large-scale invasion and the loss of their underwater carrier, Synfaxi. However, there is still concern over a possible infiltration by small-scale forces from the ground and the air. You will split into flights of two and carry out patrols in the area from Akerson Hill to the northern coastline. The airspace above the grain fields extending around Akerson is covered by our Ocean AA system. The system automatically fires missiles at any hostile aircraft it detects. Patrol the northern coastline of Akerson Hill, which is out of our AA system's range.
Captain, which plane should I use? We're launching with this formation then?
War Dog, launch. That stupid geezer base commander just won't give us a break, will he?
He's relying on us, First Lieutenant Chopper. Hey, congratulations on your promotion, by the way.
That's weird. I don't feel any better.
Hey, you two. What's your current position?
300 miles south of you.
Roger.
Damaged, but the damage is light.
Transmitting aircraft. State your assignment and current status.
Finally, a response. This is the Ocean Air Force transport plane Mother Goose 1. We're flying to the neutral country of North... We have the transmitter set to minimum power. Please come in closer so we can hear. Ah, I think this is you on our radar. Can you see us? We'd like you to guide us to a safe passage corridor through the AA defenses. We're on a top secret mission and are not transmitting a valid friendly ID signal to the ground-based automatic defense systems. As a result, a friendly surface-to-air missile was mistakenly fired at us. We narrowly avoided a direct hit, but our radar system was destroyed, and we can't fly a safe path through the PD system.
Guide the transport plane through the AA system's radar coverage and take it to Ickerson Hill. The transport is on a top-secret mission, so its ID signal has not been registered in the AA system's database. As a result, if the transport is picked up by the AA system, it may be shot down by our own missile fire. The engagement zone of this ground-based AA system is displayed on your radar. Due to combat damage, the transport's radar system is inoperable, and its maneuverability restricted. Guide the plane so it stays out of the AA system's engagement zone.
The Air Defense Command just received multiple radar hits on an enemy formation closing on your position. First bad guys we've seen crossing the pond for a while. Warning alarms are going off like mad, but we're the only ones near enough to intercept them in time. Hold on, baby. We're coming to your rescue.
Understood. I'm counting on you two. Blaze, can you see the transport craft? You should be able to confirm its position on the radar map.
Okay, I've got him on my radar. Just like the intelligence said. The radio's picking up the enemy's voice. These guys sound as beautiful as Thunderhead. Sweet as a rose, I tell ya.
Don't let up just because it's a transport plane. If we take out this guy, they won't just give us a medal. They'll build a statue in our honor. This cargo's certainly worth that much.
Is that the enemy speaking? What are these guys talking about?
Don't worry about that. We need your escort. We're completely defenseless.
Well now, this is turning out to be a weird little race against the enemy.
Mother Goose One, any problems on your end?
No problems, but we'd like to get out of this airspace ASAP.
Mother Goose One, push to radio frequency 136 megahertz.
Roger, switching. Please fly a course that avoids the AA system. Engines at max power. This is the best I can do. Ocean Air Force fighter pilot, can you see us? Please find us quickly. We should be showing up on your radar. My plane's damaged, so I can't put undue stress on the airframe. As much as you can, try to fly in a straight line for me. I never thought the skies over our own country could be so unfriendly.
Safety. Caution. Pull up.
That's good. I appreciate it if you could minimize your turns.
Warning! We have oil pressure problem on the right engine.
I'll take the controls. You check the instruments for me. Look forward and take a deep breath. Stay calm.
It's okay. It was just a sensor malfunction.
Requesting vectors to the next leg of the route.
We'll be out of the AA defense system's coverage shortly.
Oh, by the way, our plane isn't as agile as yours, so please... Too. This is Mother Goose 1. We've successfully navigated through the AA system. Thank you. However, I'd like to ask for your continued escort.
Enemy spotted on radar. Coming head on. Chopper team has arrived.
Hey, kid. We're under your command now.
Mother Goose 1, we'll take care of him. Please separate at maximum speed.
Please, I'm counting on you. We need your cover. You're our only hope.
Additional enemy targets on radar. Mother Goose 1, please keep your current vector.
Roger. Roger. Damn it.
Your speed's decreasing. What's the matter?
Mechanical trouble. I'm losing thrust on Engine 1.
Hey! I see escort fighters!
I thought there weren't gonna be any escorts.
Hey, get back in your seat. Don't approach the... Hey, what are you doing?
Hey, it's Dutch rolling!
This is transport plane, Mother Goose 1. The captain's been shot.
What?
There was a spy in the crew. Two of the engines have shut down.
Hey! What kind of cargo you got in there? Is it something dangerous? Hey, you there?
The captain's dead and the co-pilot was wounded by a stray bullet. Tommy's holding the stick now, but he's just a secretary. He's never piloted a plane before.
So who are you?
I guess you would call me the cargo on this plane.
Surrounding airspace is clear of enemy aircraft. Is A-OK.
The transport plane is ready for an emergency landing. Mother Goose 1, landing confirmed. Are you all right, Mr. Cargo?
Yeah, I guess. That was a pretty smooth ride, actually.
Mr. Cargo, I've got a question I'd like to ask you.
What is it?
The Bird of Peace. Did you really have to use that beautiful white bird for this war? Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I wanted to see your Bridge of Peace span into outer space.
It's still possible. Thanks to the bird, we're on even terms now. I'm trying to get to North Point, because I believe we have a chance.
To hold talks in neutral territory.
Right. Communication is vital.
So I can still believe in you, then. I don't want to see any more young men or women lose their lives.
Me neither.
Uh-oh. I'm out of fuel. This is the Ocean Air Force 8492nd Squadron. We observed the emergency landing on our radar. Can you see us? You can leave the rest to us. We'll provide support until the transport plane's crew is rescued.
Roger, 8492nd. Take care of them for us.
Sure thing.
We've received a sitrep from Central Command. The crew on board the transport plane you encountered during your patrol has been rescued by the 8492nd Squadron. That is currently all the information we have.
After my article, The Four Wings of Sand Island, was published to wide acclaim, I grew bolder. Here was a profile view of the base commander, the emperor of this base.
Don't. He's in a bad mood today. If he catches you, he'll have your head.
What happened?
The Ark Bird.
Huh?
The white bird in outer space. With Yuktabania outclassing us in firepower, it was the President's one trump card in the peace negotiations. And now, it's fallen right out of our hands.
So you're saying we don't know how long the war will drag on? The Ark Bird. A superweapon capable of attacking from space, far beyond the reach of the enemy. Its power generator was destroyed by explosives planted inside a supply shipment launched from Earth. Once again, the balance of power had tipped toward Yuktabania.
Our army is finally ready to conduct a large-scale counterattack against Yuktabania. If we succeed, we'll never have to face the humiliation of those Yuks trampling on our homeland again. The goal of this operation is simple. To invade and occupy the Yuktabanian mainland.
We're going to conduct a large-scale amphibious assault against Yuktabania on the Vostok Peninsula. This mission will be called Operation Footprint. The landing force will be selected from the 1st and 2nd Ocean Army Battalions. They will be divided into four companies, A, B, C, and D, and transported to the area via landing craft. Upon landing, each division will fan out and destroy the enemy bases scattered throughout the area, then rendezvous and reform into a single large force unit to assault the final target, the fortress. The Yuktobanian defense positions along the coast are tightly dug in, and we have concluded that air attacks alone will not be enough to destroy them. Therefore, Operation Footprint will be a synchronized air and ground attack to neutralize these positions. It is critical that you follow the specific targeting instructions of the ground commander to maximize the effects of your attacks. We are expecting poor weather conditions and fierce resistance from the Yuktobanian defense forces. The fortress is protected by pillboxes and a defensive wall. Provide close air support for the ground forces and get as many soldiers as possible inside.
I wish you the best of luck in battle.
Captain, which plane should I use?
So, we're going up in this formation? War Dog, launch.
Blaze, you are cleared for takeoff.
got something I need to tell you.
The enemy's right in front of us, Scott. Save it for later.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Later, then.
The four companies will now land at their designated beachheads. Commence close air support.
This is Company D. We're almost at the beach.
Go! Move forward! You're almost there! That's it! Row! Keep rowing!
To hell with this war.
This is Company A. Landing successful. Deploy the armored vehicles now!
Move! Move! Land already! Hit that beach and start running! There's no time to kiss the ground!
Just do what you were trained to do, and you can win this!
Signal
suck the Synfax he mixed in there somewhere?
Fox 2! Fox 2!
We're getting shot at from everywhere!
Calm down. Check the direction of the incoming fire. All vehicles, lay down suppression fire on the enemy's hotspots.
Well done! Give him one more shot!
Fox 2! Missile hit.
Spread out a little, will you? We'll get our tail shot off bunched up like this.
We're getting surrounded, dammit!
Our weapons alone won't suffice.
This operation is pointless.
Visibility is
These guys are just gonna storm in head on following orders. That's how war is fought. That's why I hate it.
How could the president authorize an escalation of the war like this? This is insane. We'll get bogged down in this forever.
Hey, that Mr. Cargo guy was the president, right?
Man, I thought I could believe in him back then. I had no idea he was such a wuss.
No, he's not.
Damn, it's like they're plowing the ground with bullets.
Don't get hit, Terry. I still got something I gotta tell you.
I know, Messenger Boy. You hang in there, too.
This isn't looking good! Our firepower's deteriorating!
Attention, overhead aircraft. This is the ground forces. Make sure you don't drop any bombs on us. Roger. We trust you.
Attack them before they're ready.
I'm sending tanks your way.
The enemy's not playing around.
Roger.
I don't care. I'm not gonna take any more orders from that guy.
Radar lock.
After intense fighting, the landing force captured and secured the fortress target. Thanks to the success of Operation Footprint, we have secured the southeastern coast of Yuktobania. We've decided to make the fortress our first forward base on Yuktobania as we expand our combat operations inside the country. After we complete construction of our defensive positions, our ground forces will continue their advance to the final target, the capital city of Cinegrad.